मृदुल मधुर बंशी बाजे बिसरी त्रास लोक लाजे सजनी आओ आओ लो बिनह चारु नील बास हृदय प्रणय कुसुम राश हरिन नेत्रे विमल हास कुंज वन में आओ लो.
It was 1877. The literary word of Bengal was spellbound as it came across the verses of Bhanusingho Thakurer Padaboli, a collection of Vaishnava lyrics composed in Brajaboli. Bhanusingho was a pen name of young Rabindranath Tagore, who was just 16 years old then. How can a boy of 16 pen these Brajaboli lyrics with the depth of spirituality that the lyrics carry? The poet sought connection with divinity through appeal to nature and the emotional interplay of human drama. The romance between Radha and Krishna becomes one's own submission to the sovereign. 19th century to mid 20th century was the era of Renaissance in Bengal. It was a unique blend of religious and social reformers, scholars, literary giants, journalists, patriotic orators, revolutionaries, and scientists, all merging to usher in a renaissance and mark the transition from the medieval to the modern, with its intellectual roots to the Upanishads. The Tagore family of Jorashanko, Kolkata, was in the forefront of this movement. Rabindranath Tagore was born in 1861, that is on 25th of Baishak, according to Bengali calendar of the year 1268 Bangabdo, is that's why celebrated as Rabindra Jayanti every year. Rabindranath Tagore was the youngest son of Devendranath Tagore and Sharada Devi. The journey of little Rabi, the apple of the eyes of all, thus started in an environment of luminaries in the fields of literature, spirituality, education and science to become the polymath. Rabindranath Tagore was also known by many sobriquets like Gurudev, Kabi Guru and Vishwakavi, a poet, musician, artist and educationist who went on to become the first Asian to win a Nobel Prize in 1913 for his works Gitanjali, meaning offerings of song. Love for the divine and the search of soul was at the epicenter of the creations of Rabindranath.
Oh,
In this song, Akash, meaning sky, represents our soul, which is all-invasive, vast, complete in itself. Nature transforms into an object of spirituality. Tagore said, "The vastness of my heart that captures this existence is me, with all the beauty and joy of the world." Tagore was a true world citizen, as his fame attained a luminous height. For the world, he became the voice of India's spiritual heritage, and for India, he became a great institution. Rabindranath also wrote memorable romantic songs. There is a foreign influence in the composition of the song. Rabindranath always spanned to rejoice life, our every existence. It appears that the sweetest verses of love are coming from within our own hearts. Here, Shundar, the beloved, does not remain the one whom we can touch, but becomes the one from the land of our unfathomable imagination, whom we can feel but fail to touch. The changing manifestations of nature with change of seasons also intrigued him. When the merciless sun of the summer days clenches the last drop of water from the thwarting earth, leaving it to see the burning and empty sky through its blurry eyes, and then comes the monsoon, hurling majestically with the hymns of hope and solace for the future.
Show.
Monsoon was the most favorite season of poet Rabindranath Tagore. The poetic chord inside him resonated with the mercurial variations of emotions of monsoon, opening the spring of songs. Sometimes the monotony of a rain night threaded the garland with the pathos of the past. At other, his heart danced like a peacock with the rhythm of pouring rain.
সঙ্গী তুই চলে দেখবে গঙ্গে
king of seasons, spring comes to reward the austerities of the winter, to wipe all the dullness and rigor of winter with the ethereal intoxication of color, like the musician playing his magical tune across the valley of flowers, befriending them, sharing their joy and sorrow. A chord of farewell also rings somewhere underneath. I am a traveler without a way. Take me with you or come with me. Ami poth bhola ek pothik eshechi.
Amir abo আমি পথ ভোলায় পথে এসেছি, আমি পথ ভোলায় পথে এসেছি।
হি ওয়াজ নট এ মিয়ার ওয়েফেয়ারার, হি ওয়াজ এ মিউজিশিয়ান উইথ এ মিডাস টাচ, so that every time he penned something became precious, timeless. He traveled through his wonderful garden of his own creation, indifferent, oblivious of all earthly cravings, like a yogi, a true guru who was Kobi also, crossing all boundaries of contemporary to boundless eternity. Interestingly, Northeast India, with its abundance of natural beauty and colorful indigenous culture, attracted Rabindranath Tagore strongly, and he had great relations with people of the region. He paid repeated visits to Tripura, Meghalaya and Assam. He inducted Manipuri dance form in the curriculum of Vishwabharati University at Shantiniketan. This connection with Northeast was immortalized in his essays, novels, poems and dance dramas. It is impossible for us to fathom the depth of the ocean of creations of Tagore. What we can do is to revisit his spirituality, love for mankind, and the spirit of universal brotherhood transcending all barriers to make our world a better place to live. Kobi Guru, Tomake Pranam.